Radiant. And welcome everybody here to game number one between BR and Rory, where we don't have a name because I don't need one. They are just here for one thing only, and that's to get into the Shanghai Major. But that said, BR, they're thinking of doing the exact same thing. So with that in mind, let's see how everything is gonna go here on this in this game here. This is the quarterfinals. It's still best of one. The winner of this game will go up against. Give me a quick second to check it here. Stark or Burden United. And well, having that in mind, I'm @Edson_Dot. I'll be your only caster on this channel. I hope all of you enjoy it. And now let's take a quick look at everything that's going on here in the game now. We see a couple of bans coming out here for Rory in the form of the Undying, the Ayo, and the Sven. Let's go a little bit deeper into the Sven here. They are banning the Sven because previous game recovery on the PR side got a rampage with Sven. That's just all there is to it. He played pretty damn well on him as well, and they just don't want to deal with it. The game before that, actually, Cheshire Cat was playing a pretty good Dead Prophet, so they don't really want to deal with that. They saw how Dead Prophet won from Evoker mid. As Invokers want the pickups here for Rory, as well as the Earth Spirit. Earth Spirit, oh man, he's so nasty. They did change that you can't pull in your teammates unless they are put with negatives on them. 5 seconds remaining. And well, having that said, that's just what there is to it. So Earth Spirit, just annoying overall, strong hero still. If you have this crazy Earth Spirit player in your team, then well, then life is good, really, really good. So let's say what PR have to do against this: they banned out the Gyrocopter, the Vengeful, and Broodmother, as well as the Ancient Appreciation here. Appreciation, I mean. Ugh. Anyhow, they're all taken out. Don't want to deal with any of those. Nothing too special about it. Pretty common heroes to ban out or pick. Then they open up with the same thing again, or at least not the same thing. They open up with a Dazzle Beastmaster. They have opened up with this before. They've been playing Beastmaster a lot as well. And Dying is still in the pool. They have picked that hero up a couple of times as well. They might do it as well. And why would the hell would they go in a lobby 1v1? And this time around, PR, they're gonna pick up the Juggernaut as well. As the silencer, so this is gonna be a fun one. Question is it gonna be a Cheshire Cat silencer? I think so, most likely. That said, here on the side of Rory, they pick up the Witch Doctor as well as a Lone Druid here. So that's gonna be fun. You don't see him too often as he gets banned out pretty often, as he's just annoying, so yeah. The Savage Roar just makes it nearly impossible to gank him. I think this does kind of give away that Earth Spirit is gonna be support this game. Being that PR will most likely be banning out a mid a safe lane hero here. There you go, they're gonna take out the Slark, don't want to deal with him here. Yeah, he's Dark Pacting away from Aurora's pretty hefty. If you're able to get your ultimate off pre-global silence, that would also be nice. So there's another thing, yeah. 10 seconds. So we're gonna be looking at, for PR support, yes, support it is. Undying has been taken out, as well as the Vengeful and the AA. Wisp is also gone. Still, a lot of the big ones are in there. I think they might go for Rubick here for PR, just because they like Rubick. Also, stealing from Invoker is usually pretty good from Earth Spirit. A little bit less and less. You can get somehow get the stones with it, but I don't think you can. I'm not 100% sure about the. Was it the interaction with that one? Homage Doctor, well, getting an ultimate from him is always nice. Except for PR. They might pick up a Jakiro here. I think, yeah. Works pretty well with Juggernaut. Might go back for. I think that would be probably the best gift from Lockdown as well. They're a little bit lackluster in Lockdown. They really just have to roar, which is probably not going to be enough. Let's see, Bane. It's going to be the ban here from Rory. Really, the push of Rory is pretty strong once they get the levels up. Don't need the levels though. So, Let's wait for less pick here from PR. I'm not gonna talk too much about it. I'm just gonna send out some tweets and check on the Dota 2 Oracle. Have to get the retweets going from the other streams as well, so before I get punished and they start hating on me. Nah, JK. Everybody likes what we're doing here. Shout out to Corrupt Dropbear as well for setting it all up. PR Dota versus Rui. Open. So they have about 1 minute left. Still a lot of thinking time about it. So I think I'm almost done CC at Dota 2 Oracle. Here we go. Send out a tweet. And maybe we'll get some more viewers, maybe we won't. It's all fun and games anyway here. At CPR, man, they're really just want to dip into their time here. But why not? You got it. You might as well use it. So PR, they're gonna go for the Brewmaster, meaning that they're all gonna go all in on the mid game here. Late game is not an option. It's better out of time. That's gonna be fun. Haven't really had the opportunity yet to cast him. But man, I like it hero myself. The extra grade is cute. I don't think we'll see it into play as it is a little bit of a too iffy thing to use. You get 4.2K invested in it, and then you're still not 100% sure or 100% guaranteed that it's actually going to be useful. So yeah, with that in mind, it's just probably going to be Blink Dagger first into four staff BKB, those kind of things. No real reason for them to do anything else apart from that. There you go. Free camera. Allowed to move on my own now. Let's put in the console code as well. Oh shit, it of course restarted. But don't worry about it. We can just do this and we have it all back up. Looks like I can actually control a camera right now. Isn't it amazing? How am I doing? Yeah. Come. Here we go. All set up here. Ladies and gentlemen, this is PR against Rory in the quarterfinals of the Shanghai Major Open qualifier. This is the second qualifier and also the last one. The winner of this match will move on to go into the semifinals from there on. It's gonna be a best of three. And we're giving them a little bit more wiggle room if it turns into be best of threes, but this game, it's just gonna be a best of one, so everything is on the line in this one game. As here on the Rory side, we have Dale playing the lone druid here on the off lane. We have Nagare Hiswe playing the Bedrider. Vodka is gonna be playing the Ebola Spirit. 6-2-1 is gonna be the Invoker, and Nosik is gonna be playing the Witchdog here on the Dire side. For PR, Cheshire Cat is gonna be our beast master here. J4 is on the mid silencer. Or no, mid, that should just be a support silencer, my bad, bad call. Bigdom is the beast, the brewmaster here. Roman is the Dazzle. And Recovery is our Juggernaut. And with all of that done, we're gonna see how everything is gonna evolve here. The pretty normal, let's use our panda to actually call him Misha. Should probably ask him why it's called Misha. Well, doesn't matter. He's just gonna pull it all the way back, and oh, he's not pulling it back through the camps. So now they're gonna have this awkward situation here. He should be able to at least get the experience for sure, but how much is he able to really pressure them here? This will cost him a tango or two. Little bit iffy, but I guess it somehow works somewhere down the line, maybe. There is no real top team here, unless if you mean, let's say, Knowing wise, I would say PR is gonna be the favorite just because everybody knows him. It's gonna be the bad run in mid here. That's interesting. Taking a lot of damage here by J4. Pretty much a dual lane here, as both the Witch Doctor and Silencer are here to help out their respective mid cores. A nice two-man curse here, Coconut comes out, but are they really able to follow this one up? I don't think so. No, both sides are just happy with trading some harassments. Let's see Cheshire Cat here on top. He seems to be doing okay. Nothing really stopping him here. Has to lane pretty far back. I guess he pulled some away with the boar. Witch Doctor has an invisibility rune. I'm not sure if they actually saw this on the Radiant side. No, they did not. It's gonna be pretty nice. Oh, nice setup here. Bignum Dota. He actually has 4 stacks of Napalm on top of him. And with the Firefly here, he's taking so much damage. But Nagare, he needs to run away. Curse is not gonna wear off in time here. Oh, he's bottling up. He's staying alive through all of this. And with that, it's just gonna be a first blood here for Rory. And it will be unpunished by PR, apart from the kill here on bottom. But this doesn't really have anything to do with the first blood on mid. Still good to get the return kill going against the Lone Druid. He should have another bear. What? Oh, he responded somewhere in the middle. It's gonna be a minute without it. Oh, this is pretty hard for him. At least a creep wave is behind him, but he really needs it. Oi oi. See our level 3 on Witch Doctor. He's doing pretty well for himself. Let's see how's J4 doing. He's actually chilling out in the base here. Buying and selling some items. Making a null tally for now. Yeah, without a bear, you can't really stand up against this Dazzle. Just throwing out the casual potion touches on you and just harassing you all the way back to your tier 1. And there's nothing you can really do about it. He shouldn't probably even walk forward. It's not even worth it. Because the Dazzle will just walk up to him. He's even being pretty blatant about it that he's just gonna arrest him out. Question is here for Bignum. Is he... He's gonna go boots first now. After that he will finish up the magic wand. That will be the most common as well as the best way to deal with mid lane. Bad ride at least. You're gonna get a bunch of stacks. Oh, it seems like Nagare wanna try something here. He goes over him with the Firefly, still a lot of Napal stacks, and it's gonna be enough. He's gonna kill him off. He's taking a lot of damage though from the tower. He's trying to ball up between it again. He can do one more. Has to watch out for J4 here. This hit is gonna connect, but it's not gonna be enough. With the Tango Eaten, he has more than enough HP to survive. More than enough meaning 20 HP. But now on bottom, Dill, he got his panda back. Misha and Dill. Happy couple here. I see Invoker actually died on top. Okay, Dazzle rotated in and they got a kill over there. I was not paying attention to that, my bad. Let's see. This gank is absolutely not gonna work. Seeing some blue pinks, that's the bad rider? Oh yeah, they have vision here with this ward. Let's see. Also radiant vision. Mostly about mid and top, so they're not really too scared of what's going on bottom here. Ooh, that's the last worth. It's taking a bunch of damage from this one. Oh, this is so annoying, that curse. Ugh. Especially with a hero like this that just wants to spam out abilities all the time, it just starts to stack up so hefty. I really wonder what the Earth Spirit is gonna bring to the table this game. Honestly, I'm a freaking terrible Earth Spirit player, so I can't really say too much about it. I know the normal builds up for his items. His usual builds I also know. There's a bit... Yeah, this bear is actually gonna go down before they kill it. Man, the Earth Spirit is taking so much damage. Yeah, since he was it, Geomagnetic Rip has been nerfed a bit. It's not really worth that much anymore. So he went for the Boulder Smash as well as Roll. Recovery took a lot of damage there. It does have an Omni Slash. Let's see. Yeah, Roadman will just heal him up all the time. Oh, Cheshire Cat. Oh, no, buddy. They have a roll. They have a Boulder Smash as well. They're just going to roll into him first. Maybe they will kick him. Yeah, there we go. They will just kick something else here. The Sunstrike is off the mark, but will in the end still be more than able to just kill off Cheshire Cat over here. And everything just goes back to the farming state here. Let's just take a quick look at how the CS is going at the moment. There are 34 CS here on the Invoker, 641 or 621, whatever it was again. Recovery is leading with 49. Last it, and that's going to be followed up by Big Num here in the mid lane on his Brewmaster. And after that, we have Nagare. Offlaner wise, it's pretty even. Cheshire Cat has a little bit more, also has an assist. I don't think Dill has any kind of assists. Nope. So at the moment, the offlane has been won a bit more by PR. Also, they have the ultimate already up. Yeah, he's a bit ahead in experience as well. Oh, yeah, this is gonna be a dead. What? Okay, he's gonna cut down the trees, but he can't get really in position anymore. There is a split as well. Yeah, he's just gonna pop it here. It will take some time, but Nagara can't get really in place to use his lasso here, so they're gonna try and turn this one around, but. Yeah, they can't really do a whole lot, apart from just stall here and get the Earth Panda back and just have the Spirit and Fire Panda just trying to create some madness here, but... What? Ooh, what could... Oh yeah, that was too far. He just gets roared up and he's gonna die from just this. There you go, even the X is coming out to secure the kill. Noxic taking a lot of damage. Why the hell were they walking so aggressively underneath the tower? There was a little bit of miscommunication. Big Num is walking forward, gets Cold Snap, and with that they will return. There's also a little bit... Too many of those Naples stack on them. And not too nice for them. There you go. Just doing some quick stuff on YouTube now as well. Just finished uploading two videos. Let's see. This is Midas. That's Midas. So it's pretty basic on the Invoker. My big question is what's the Vrotka Dotka gonna do? Well, or Vodka Vrotka. Vodka Vrotka. Holy shit, what a name. Anyhow, he really has nothing to his name here. Was it a smoke? There was a smoke. So he's just gonna go on this personal warding mission here. Maybe go. Into a gank on bottom as well. It's not level 6 just yet. Nope, he just placed a ward. He wants to try and place one aggressive as well. I think he saw Big Num walking there. J4 is there as well. He needs to place it now or it's not going to work. Okay, he got spotted and he's like, okay, I'm not going to do this anymore. He's like, I'm not going to do anything here. And he just pings out that there are people over there. We'll take the long route around. We'll maybe place one down on the pillar. There you go. I always think that the pillar is over here. Still from the old one. Not the best thing for me. I'll admit it. It's not good. Oh, he's going for Big Num here. Oh, he's dead. Nice Sunstrike. Perfectly on mark, especially with the cast there as well. All set up here by Noseek. Well played by him. Getting his level 6 from there as well. Big gank coming out from him. Really also a lot of patience. So... Okay, so the two matches from before are now published on YouTube as well, so you can just go there and check them out. Sorry about that, I'm completely back for now. And let's see, what can he do? How's the Blink Dagger going? Oh, well, we'll talk about it. It's a pretty timing Blink Dagger, ready. Recovery's there. Do they want to go for him? He is going up. The Panda sees him, dragging him back. But the Global Silence comes out. Can he kill Recovery time? I don't think so. He's just turning this one around with an Omni Slash. Not enough damage for now. Savage is going to pull them back a bit. He goes into the spin, doing a lot of damage. Now the Roar comes out. Cheshire Cat rotated, and they're going to turn this one around on the Bad Rider for now. Dill has to run away. Even the Earth Spirit came in, but it's not going to be enough. Big Num has a split up. Can't really go for a gank on him now. Especially with Lester down. It's going to be down for another 60 seconds as well. They don't have the control really to keep him there then. Maybe if the Earth Spirit comes in. Spin hitting Cheshire Cat. But in the end, you're still gonna get the tower. Regardless of him hitting a stone or not. It seems that Stark Esports have won from Burden United here. At least that's what the Twitter feed is showing me, so just a quick update for you guys about that. You always go 2-1-1? Okay, I thought you go 1-1-1. So apparently you always go 2-1. Didn't know that. Double damage. 1 second stun? Thought you always get the stun. Stun duration goes almost up but double though. Recovery didn't go for the Roshan build. That said, they're putting pressure on it, at least showcasing that they might want to go there. They have a bunch of summons as well. Also, I waited my time, but Brewmaster is actually pretty okay at taking Roshan. Having a miss chance as well as a crit helps out a lot. Also, Drunken Haze is just annoying for Roshan. Miss him all the time. Ugh. You gotta hate him. Is this gonna be a Midas for Dill as well? Might be a Midas, or he's going back for the Maelstrom. See both builds coming out a lot. Depends a bit of the situation in the game. At this moment, it depends on the game plan. I guess they just want to hold on for now, as PR is really ahead with a little bit, and but also grouping up a bit more and showcasing that they want to take towers more aggressively than the side of Rory wants. So yeah. And I'm also working a bit on the YouTube stuff right now. Just want to get it all done. So this should be okay for now. There were some mistakes before. Didn't update one thing. So. Okay, that's already okay. We're back into the game. Nothing happened. That's why I did it. Did of course have it on my second screen. Nagara is looking for initiation angle here on someone. Seems to be building for the Eidolons. Having the cloak. Don't think Glimmer Cape is too good on him. Costs too much of his mana. Save them really. Why would you go Eidolons? What else can he really go with this? Phil? Oh, Hoot. I don't think going Pipe is a good call on him. You're better off getting a 4-step then. It's just too weird. Also, there's a lot of physical damage also on the side of PR, so it won't really neglect too much. So far, it's just going to be the tier 1 here taken. It's going to be the Midas on the lone route. As well on the Evoker, meaning that they're actually not really ready to fight. Oh, I just remembered I forgot to put on the net worth. Anyhow, it's 7k right now in recovery. Or now 8k. It's a tier 1 for tier 2 in the end, so yeah. They're all taking it pretty easy here. They don't really want to commit. None of them really want to. Still, the tier 1s for both sides are still. This should be a pretty major point of contest for both sides. You don't really want to give it up. It's so much rush down access that you get, as well as overall map control that you lose with it. Both sides putting some heavy emphasis on staying there. Though PR seems to be getting themselves ready as Roman put down this aggressive ward between the two tier. Between the two towers, essentially. Yeah. So, well, that's getting ready. This is. Oh, the smoke! Completely spotted out! Straight underneath the ward! Random boulder toss into that. Oh! But now comes the global. Recovery is not going to go down in this time. He gets up the Omnistage level 2. So just ripping through them. That's going to be the Bed Rider down now. 6-2-1 is going to go down. Death Ward is going here on the back lines, but it's not dealing enough damage. And now Nosik is even going to get focused down and going to get killed. Is it 3-4? Well, nothing essentially as the bear gets put into the air. They're going to just start focusing him down now, maybe. Leave him there. And, oh, actually, sorry. Bagnum is going aggressive. But he will just go back for now. And with that, the Arctic, a good fight here. Killing of 3, losing no one, and even taking the tier 1 as an extra price here as Rory. Even gonna go for the tier 2 here. Yeah. It's actually not like Rory can really defend this. Most of their ultimates are on cooldown now. They can try to delay it, but I think Nagara has to look out before they jump him. Bignum doesn't have mana for it, so they will just let it go. Actually, almost all of them don't have any mana. So it's going to be Tress completed on J4 here. Recovery actually has the Mental Steel completed here. Let's see, what has to get the silence off, of course, from the... from the Earth Spirit. Pretty nice to get that one away. And casual stroll into Roshan. And there are no observer wards down here from PR, so they're in the complete dark here. And they might just be able to get away with this uncontested. It's already down to half HP. Cheshire Cat's not in place. Stone get tossed. It's not really far. This is going to be a dead Roshan. Nicely and sneakily taken by Rory. And just like that, it's going a little bit more in favor back, or at least it's going to go a little bit more backwards towards Rory's favor. Having that Aegis on the Invoke will allow them to go a little bit more aggressive, but at the same time, PR are ready for that to get off the roar. Nice Lesser bringing them all back, but with this Global Silence coming out, keeping everybody there, they can't really do a whole lot as 6-1 is also not going down. Oh, there's an Yule's on the bed rider, keeping in the back, and there you go, Omnisash coming out on the back line, recovery, cleaning up over there. They're already down on 3, now 6-1 is going to be the next target of choice. He's going to go down as well. With that, this is going to be another 4 kills here for PR. If we include the Aegis, it's actually 5. Do we have a teamfight fight recap coming up? Yes, it's not the buyback or anything used by Bedrider. He actually survived through it all. And with that, what do PR want to do? It seems like they're willing to just go down mid lane here. Try and end this game. Again, most ultimates are on cooldown now on the side of... Oh, that was a close one. Stone connecting on 3, but like I said, no ultimates to follow it really up. Mantis also pretty nice to just have this coconut bounce around, taking it away. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. And they're just gonna start a little bit of split pushing at the same time. Tower's gonna be pushed in here on bottom, but seems like recovery is already more than ready to go there. See Bignum went for the flats, going more for the core oriented bit. Brewmaster build, I like this more myself as well. Gives you more potential to farm skills later into late game as well, and you're just more useful for your team. Let's see, J4. It's building towards the World of Atos. What is this? This is a 4-step actually, never mind. That's nice, will help us out this team as well. Nice mobility coming out. Cheshire Cat has a blink, has a Necronomicon level 1 as well, so he will just start building it up into a level 3. Will make the push so much stronger. Recovery, he has another 2k goal. We'll see what he goes for next. Might be a blink dagger. But does it go back for... What really does he want here? BKB is not too bad either, but maybe a little bit too early for that. AC is not really something I would pick up on him. Maybe go for Skadi. Just making yourself more tanky overall is always nice. You don't need to get any lifesteal as there is a Brewmaster with an with the flats. So that's not too needed. And That said, Batrider, what's he going for? I guess it was just a casual cloak, not really building it into anything. He just needs a little bit more for the four staff, about 500. That would be nice for him. 6-1 is going to be building up towards his Agnims here. It's getting pretty close, just 2k off for now. Let's see what's Dale going for. For the Radiance, he actually already bought the recipe on his beer. This might, yeah, he should have probably just put the recipe in the base instead of taking it with him on where it's kind of obvious what you're going for now. You're just showing it. There's now Bignum is going to be found. Now the Global Science come out, meaning that Bignum should be able in the end to pop his ultimate here. He's going to get cold snapped up for now, keeping him here. Okay, do they have the control? No, the Grave comes out, and now Bignum will surely be able to pop his ultimate. How is the turn going to come around here? No, see, he can't cast his ultimate anymore. He's just going to go down here without ever being able to cast it. Maybe he is able to TP in time. Boulder comes out and kills him off. Bignum picking up the kill, and in the end, the gank will on Bignum will just return into a Primus Plate use and a kill for him. Lone Druid, they're actually going to get a kill here on the Beastmaster. He was a little bit aggressive. Nice killing spree going the way of Dale. Should get close to his Radiance because of it. Yeah, just 1k off of there. Rory, yes, that's the team name. Let's put it. Okay, it's on game chat. Always good to check out, of course. So. Opa, it's all back. So, still about the same thing. Let's see what's going to be the plan here for PR. I think Roshan is probably the thing that both sides are going to be looking at mostly. Yeah, they just showed it. It will take another 4 minutes or so for before it gets back. PR still bit ahead, but I don't think they really want to force it with just 5k. That's a little bit too hard. So for PR, I guess it's just making sure that they're out for keep them out farming the side of Rory, and then just go for. Well. Just go for a Roshan fight, or maybe if they can fortify somewhere. Like I said, I don't think they will want to force a fight. They just want to take it easy, and especially with the ultimate still down for now. So it's actually Basher here for Juggernaut. That's also okay, pretty old school, nice build. Just overall, pretty strong item on him. Let's see what's it going to be for Bignum. He just finished up his strats. Anyhow, Earlands is going to be the item for Dazzle. Cheshire Cat, about 700 off his Necrobook over here. J4 has completed his 4 staff. Okay, they're ready again. Let's see, what can Rory do in the same time? I think they also need to hold on and go for a good fight here. They almost have the Mechanism or Earth Spirit. They might be able to force some kind of fight somewhere using that. But even then, there is still a lot of damage coming out from PR. So they have to watch out a little bit with it. It's not like they can just do whatever they want. So it's also NLG against No Logic Gaming. That's actually 70 minutes. NLG against LC. As Bignum goes in, just a random clap coming out. And now the Global and the backline's recovery is going after them. They're able to put 6-1 into the air. At least he himself tried to do that. But in the end, it won't really save him, as now they're just putting up more and more. His recovery will be dragged back here. They pick up another panda, going at recovery, but now comes out the Omnisense, doing a lot of damage. Vodka, Dotka is gonna go down, or Vodka, whatever his name, the Earth Spirit is. And with that, there's another 3 people down here on the side of Rory and PR. Say, like, okay, well, we're all 5, we're just gonna take your tier 3 for now on mid. Thank you very much. Gonna go for your melee racks right now. As the Radiance is still not completed here, Dio is getting close, and I don't think he gets. He's gonna get this before this game ends. As there we go, Silencer. Just get a casual kill on Nagare. Now. Melee barracks have been taken. Range Wreckers has been focused down. J4, he's gonna get out in time as the cask has not been able to be casted here. At least we know who is going to be the opposition here. against BR or Rory. It's gonna be Stark. So it's always good to know. Keep an eye on that. Let's see, no seek. Level 9 here. Not really anything new for him. Checking out Roshan here. It's a little bit too early, so 20 seconds before the 8 minute mark is even reached. But you can never really start too early with checking it, I guess. Yeah, nothing really interesting on the Earth Spear. It's kind of boring if you play him as a support like this. I was hoping to see something more fun out of him. Tissier Cat is looking for Nosik. Yeah, just gonna boot up the Hawk to give a vision as well as the Necro Books. Man, that is so much damage with the Necro Tree there. And with Witch Doctor done, it's just for 30 seconds. I don't think they can really breach the base in this time. Might get some damage in, but even then, I think it's gonna be pretty nominal. Oh, this might work. Omnisense coming down, the Gyra going down. Random kick into recovery, but it's just to make some space for himself to get back, as the Maelstrom has also been completed on the Juggernaut here. Ooh, recovery, nope, he just spins through it all. Oh, it's actually the Radiant has been able to complete it, but what can he do in damage-wise? He just throw up the bear for now, they don't really care too much about it, as Global Science comes out. It's pretty much just zoning them back, but they're not really able to do anything with it. As they're throwing the bear again into there, he's just Radiant and burning away because of it. Treasure Cat in the back, Witch Doctor Ultimate will zone now. The side of PR back as Roman is found in the trees and is gonna be killed up. Big Num slowed for a bit. Gonna get kicked. Oh yeah, this is gonna focus him down and kill him. They're done with his jokes. He's out. Did they even take the tower here? They did take the tower. Recovery went, I think, mid even. Yeah. To go and push it out there. In the end, they lost two heroes PR, but they got a lot of control again. Mid lane is now open and destroyed, and the bottom lane has now an exposed set of wrecks. Oh yeah, now you can see it coming back. 12k net worth for PR, and this experience is a little bit less. They're 5-manning a lot. But again, Roshan here, Rory are just able to take it. Do the range and vision of this. They kind of see Nagare flying around here. So they're gonna send in some illusions, but Roshan's already down to 400 HP and now 0. So they take an Aegis here for themselves again here. The second Aegis of the game is also gonna go the way of Rory. PR again, not really in a position to stop this. There's even going to be the Aether Lens here for Witch Doctor as well. That's going to be some pretty nice range. Damn. That's not 700 range. That's absolutely not 700 range. That's 900, yeah. Thought so. Oi, oi, oi. That's going to do some damage, for real. But again, PR, they don't seem to care too much about the Aegis. They just keep on aggressively pushing out all the lanes, getting the Hawks out for vision, seeing if someone is trying to prepare some kind of gank, and then jump him, kill him off, and go for the team fight afterwards. Oh, what? They want to go in here. Vodka comes in. What can he really do? They put back J4. J4 might just go down. No, in the time, Ming Matter comes out the grave. He can put Global. No, he's just going to let it go for now. But this might just be the fight here that they want to take for Vodka. Rory, nah, recovery going through. Deal's going to get low. Deal's going to get down. Doesn't have the Aegis either. And then Nosik, he's going to be focused up. Boulder comes out. Recovery trying to spin close to him, but the force staff will keep him alive. Making aggressively forward. Going to get hit by the stone here as everybody's trying to retreat here. As he's also trying to get back. Now the Witch Doctor Ultimate comes out, but it's just going for the illusions. Little bit wasted, I guess. And PR, they tried one for one and then are more than happy to just go back to the base. Jessica though, he says, yeah, I have a BOT, so I'll just start split pushing a bit here. Our spirits still has to grieve now. I get, yeah, it's good against global silence, but still, it's such a boring item build on him. If you pick this hero, at least go fun or something. This ward is gonna get dewarded, probably. At least if they can get vision of it with the Hulk, then they see it with the sentry. They have about 2 minutes to do that. How close is recovery? Something, here we go. How close recovery? He actually finished up a Mjolnir. Opting to not finish up his Abyssal Blade and first go for this pushing item. And he has an Invis rune. And they're not spotted. Dale is gonna go into his jungle. Putting in the boar first. Of course, Misha has to be the scout, but they seem to be going a different route here. Noseek, can you find him? Oh, they see him. I think Noseek was looking somewhere else as he was still walking pretty deep into them. Get a ward down here as well. So there's a lot of vision here from the side of PR into the enemy base. Oh, Devin Nagara, he is going to go down as well. He needs to buy back. Yes, there you go. Buyback is used. Cheshire Cat is able to evade the Chaos Meteor here. Punch is not going to come through either. And at the same time, Bignum is going into the back here. He needs to get off his place. Can he get it off? He can't get it off. He actually goes down here. Now 6-1 recovery is going to get directly to the Sunstrike put back as well. But there comes out the Grave. Does he still have his ultimate? Yes, he does. He's going through Omni Slashing away here. But in the end, he will just go down here to the Earth Spirit. Now Roman is going to be on the next two kill list. And he goes down. Melee barracks have been taken. Ranged are down to over half HP. All in all, PR at least taking some structural damage. Or doing some structural damage, but losing a lot. In the end, it will result in about a 5k swing towards the side of Rory here. Though the kill score is 21-11, they're still pretty damn far ahead. No sick. Can't really go for ganks here anymore. Cheshire Cats. Is this gonna be a Lotus? This is either gonna be a Lotus or a Lincoln's. Don't really see a reason for any other items. Guess Refresher is nice, but I think the build up is a little bit too long for this game as well. A Lincoln's or a Lotus is just so good against a Bad Rider. I'm not saying bullshit, yes, both items are made by Perseverance. How's the chat doing, guys? As the game is already going into the 33 minutes here, how are you guys all doing? Still holding up? What do you think? Can Rory come back from this deficit? Being behind so much in structural damage as well as just don't having any map control? Or is PR just gonna end this one? These Sunstrike are way too easy, or easy early on the Roshan pit all the time. It's not even nearing its coming back, to say it like that. It's respawn time. It's not even close. Kind of surprises me that he keeps on spawning it so early. They should have just taken the time, and I'm pretty sure they would have or have done that. They're putting a little bit too much emphasis about around Roshan right now, while they actually were the ones taking it. Here you go, another pause coming out. Be right back. I guess both sides are just gonna go take a small break here. Maybe some internet issues on the side of PR. As a 5-man, holy shit! Did they just get a power outage? Whoa. There are okay, they just disappeared. Maybe power outage or something. Asking the manager now. We'll get an answer pretty soon. I hope, of course. So, you bet. This small break, I'm just gonna get something to drink real fast. Tomorrow the BTS Hub is also gonna start. I was kind of expecting them to start during the open qualifiers already, but they seem to not be too willing to do that. I'm actually gonna tell a little bit. Like, we have a break now. I don't really wanna go too much into the game. I'll do it later. I just wanna say a little bit about where I live right now. I live here in Groningen, and that's in North End. We've been struck by a lot of cold weather. Like, it's freezing, and the. Actually, like, walking on the street is pretty dangerous. Earlier today, I was looking out of my window, and I actually saw a little girl, I think it was 14 years old or 13, whatever. Going on the street with ice skates on. She was just actually ice skating-ish on the street in front of my house. That's how bad it is here. And it's really just everything is closed pretty much as well because it's just too dangerous to go outside and I still need to do grocery shopping later. So I might just break my leg by just walking over the street here, which is not really gonna be good. I can't even take my bike. It's just too slippery for that. If I step on my bike, when I take even one turn, it's. She's all gone. Something Russian from J4. Man, I was in the lobby. Let's take a look how good are the matches watched right now. Just really PR going on at the moment. 3.7K viewers. Yeah, Roger, the one from previous game against PR. There he is already playing another pub here. Magnums has been completed here on 6-1 as well. Getting an extra point in all of his orbs is always nice. Also, the lowered cooldown is pretty damn fucking good, to be honest. AC has now been completed on the Brewmaster as well.
Nice meme.
I actually just clicked on nice meme when you guys hear the sound. Break mirrors with my face? What? Oh, break mirror with my face. I break mirrors with my face. Okay, I got it. I got it. Oh, this break, man. It's so bad. Okay. It's kind of fun to see how Obi-Wan just take all the fuse away that Odie Pixel had before. I thought Modpacks was also streaming. I guess he is not getting too many today. Where is he at? Joker is streaming. Dreyse is also doing something. I guess Modpacks maybe stopped already for today. No, he's there. Stark versus. Okay, he's also waiting for this game to end. He has about 220 viewers. Also, good caster. I think after this game, I might be gone. So, yeah. Just waiting for the last person here. It's gonna be Roman to come back. Then we'll go again. Okay, yeah, there was a bit of a power outage here at the PR Gaming House. Asked for confirmation about that from the manager said yes. So I'm not just talking bullshit here. And we got the Stark fanboy here. Hoping that Stark will have an easy time in the semifinals against a team called Rory. Set of VR. And I actually already have info for the next match. Ooh. I can tell you this, ladies and gentlemen. In the upcoming 5 minutes, this game is gonna end. And it's not gonna end well for one of these two sides. One of these two teams will be eliminated. Having their dreams destroyed to go to Shanghai to participate in the major qualifier. Oh, even that is just so bad. So bad for them. They just really wanted to. They put so much time in it. They got so far, but one of them is gonna see their dreams shattered as PR. I'm gonna start pushing into this top lane. They think it has taken long enough. The lead has stagnated 10k and 5k experience. Can they find the initiation that they need to whirl? They'll not be able to do so and get counter initiated and lose the teamfight, and then from there on maybe lose their base and it all be gone with just this one attack. For now, it seems we are able to keep the creep wave a little bit back, not letting it go up to the high ground here. They have about 15 minutes to reconnect, to answer the question from the chat there. They can indeed be disqualified for being, well, paused for too long. If you pause for more than like 15 minutes, you're gonna get a dev loss thrown your way. Let's see, Misha here, the panda that is gonna build for Mjolnir right now. Has been able to farm pretty nicely here, about 18k net worth. Has been able to take over 6-1. But yeah, it's will it be enough? That's the question. Both sides just taking it easy. When's Roshan gonna be up? It's gonna be up in the upcoming 1.5 minutes. That might just be the point of contest. AC is now also completed on the side of Rory. It's gonna be the lone druid to pick it up. Didn't go for the Mjolnir, but went for the AC with the Hyperstone there. Moonstone would have been weird. Recovery running in. Setting up a trap here. They go in with the roar into the backlines? Where the hell are they? Oh no, Batrider tried to be sneaky, but there was an hog. Okay, now they need to wait for the blink daggers. Yeah, now you kind of wish that you went to better for your build on recovery. Look at this, it's just going aggressive to find another one. There's gonna be known sick already done. These blink daggers on PR just doing massive work, and there are no buybacks here on the side of Rory. And he's not in here to go back. Oh, link forward. Straight into split, looking for the tornado on the bear. Just gonna keep him there. They're just zoning them out while they're trying to take the tower here. They can just go and spin. Oh, he actually just goes in BKB. Doesn't really care too much about it. As the Dazzle Cutter of the Earth Spirit here on the top. Dale has now been slowed by the Rod of Atos coming out from J4. Cold Stamp is on him. He's taking a lot of damage. He might just die here. Nope, they're just gonna leave him alone. That is, until the Sun Strike does connect there. Dale goes down. Raman doesn't have any more mana, but at the same time, there are no heroes really alive here to stop the Mega Creeps or this push into the Tier 4, and GG has been called by Rory here. PR are gonna go into the next one. They're gonna be phasing up against Stark. With all of that said, we are gonna be shutting down the stream fairly soon. I would say, guys, go to modpacks and watch the game there. Gonna help out the other small casters. And with that, this is Sander. I'm gonna be signing out here on the channel. We'll put on some music first, put on some beats, and upload the match soon. Hope to see you guys all again once I start streaming again. It will be well, it's actually a team house in Minsk by PR. Pretty nice. Having that said,